The government has proposed a raft of changes to building laws to make it easier for prefab homes to be produced en masse in a bid to address the housing crisis. The Building and Construction Minister, Jenny Seelisa, revealed today the first changes she'll be making early next year. They aim to cut red tape by reducing the time and money it takes to get building consent. Madison Reedy has the details.
Prefab homes have been touted as a potential solution to the housing crisis. The homes are designed and built in a factory, then tracked out to wherever you'd like to plant it. Manufacturers offer one-bedroom studios on wheels for 20 grand or multi-million dollar houses. The government today announced it wants to see more prefabs used to house the homeless.
These changes will especially help those who are homeless. These kinds of prefab houses will ensure that we get to house more of our people who are homeless, those who are needing transitional houses.
The Building and Construction Minister, Jenny Seelisa, has committed to changing the Building Act.
We're going to cut the red tape and make consenting dramatically easier and more efficient for modern methods of building and construction. This includes prefabricated housing and off-site manufacturing like what you see here at House Me. The changes will create a new nationwide end-to-end pathway for manufacturers where we only will need one building consent instead of two.
The changes also include a reduction of the building levy, a requirement for information about building products, and much higher penalties for those who don't comply, of up to $1.5 million for companies. Prefab manufacturer HouseMe pumps out 200 homes a year for an average sale price of $70,000. It has the space to increase that to 500 homes per annum. HouseMe's national sales manager, Bryce Glover, says the changes will make it easier to scale up.
Anything that's going to improve efficiencies is pretty important to us.
You sell these things, who's buying them?
Quite a few different markets. We're seeing workers' accommodation in the rural and horticultural sector. We're seeing those people definitely getting a lot of traction there. Holiday parks, but then just the basic end user, someone that's got access to some land that they want to maximise the potential of.
So what are prefab buyers in for?
I've got, you know, bedroom storage, kitchens, full functioning kitchen with a fridge, oven, hob, splash pit, rain shed, breakfast bar, living room.
No walk-in wardrobe though?
No, but we can build you one if you really want to.
The changes are expected to cut the number of building inspections in half. The Ministry of Business, Innovation and Employment's Deputy Chief Executive for Building Resources and Markets, Chris Bunny, says cutting red tape won't solve all of the construction industry's woes, but it helps.
We are hampered by challenges. We have workforce issues. We have 250,000 people that currently work in construction, but we've got a shortage of tens of thousands of people, and as more demand comes on and as the industry kind of turnover happens, that's not going to be fixed anytime soon. So initiatives like modern methods of construction, getting higher productivity, a whole series of things will actually make a big difference.
Jenny Seelisa doesn't know how many extra homes the changes will add to the market. And National's building spokesman Andrew Bailey isn't convinced prefabs are the answer.
They might count for maybe 2,000 homes if you're lucky. But we build so many more houses than that, and that's why having an over-reliance or being preoccupied with prefabrication is not necessarily the outcome we want. We want to make sure that prefabrication occurs, but secondly, and more importantly, we need to make sure the existing systems work, and they don't.
The government is still working on a reform of the Resource Management Act and is working with the construction industry after signing an accord earlier this year. Today's announcement is the foundation of the government's building reforms. We'll have to wait until next year to hear more details about the walls and roof to go with it. For Checkpoint, I'm Madison Reedy.